Week flies by, and game day's tomorrow. First really true road game for Oklahoma. First conference game of the year. It's still not... feels weird to say that Cincinnati's a conference game, but it's only temporary because kind of like Lone Star in Spaceballs. At last we beat for the first time, for the last time. Kind of. First time as a conference game and the only time as a conference game. So, alright, so this is a game a lot of people have circled for a while now. This is a game that, oh man, Oklahoma go up there and lose. This is a game they could lose. This is the first of like a handful that people will... it's this one, Texas, BYU. Some people pick Kansas. Those are the popular choices for OU to get a loss. If you watch the first few weeks of the season, you know, you might have changed your mind. You say, oh, Cincinnati lost to Miami of Ohio last week. Oklahoma's looked pretty good for the most part the first 3 weeks. So there's going to be a happy medium here when it comes to that. This is my take on Cincinnati. I know they lost last week, and it was a very embarrassing loss for them because they don't lose at home very often, and they never lose to Miami of Ohio. That one was caught them off guard just a little bit. They're not used to losing that rivalry game, and yes, it is a rivalry game. For OU, it's like this feels like more of a mental challenge than anything. You look on paper, OU's the more talented team. We all know this. Someone's going to bring up Dillon Gabriel's record against Cincinnati or Satterfield, their head coach. I don't think that's going to come into play here. It's just the fact, can Oklahoma go up there and play their game? Now look, despite the loss and Cincinnati fans being mad online about everything, that campus is ready. They are hyping up being in the Power 5 now. This is their one big shot. So eggs in one basket type of deal here if you're Cincinnati. They want to make a showing. They want to make themselves heard that, hey, you know what? We're in the Power 5 now, and we're going to make some noise. My feeling is this. Emotion can carry you for like a quarter, maybe half a quarter. After that, it's football. You might see a situation where emotion's going to get them going for a little bit. Kind of like the Nebraska game last year, where it's like, hey, Nebraska's going to make it a game. And then once things calm down a little bit, the more talented team takes over. I expect Cincinnati to get theirs. I expect them to make a few plays here and there. And people watching with me tomorrow are all going to panic or whatever. But at the end of the day, passing game's too strong. Dillon Gabriel's playing really well. The key matchup for me, I think for everyone who pays attention, is the offensive line versus the defensive line. How's Caden Green going to hold up as a left guard? He had to be an emergency backup left guard last week. He took on that role, Savion Byrd out for the moment. We'll see how long he's out. But Caden Green played pretty well last week. I know it was Tulsa, but he came in and he could have been worse, but he wasn't. He was pretty solid. So, you got Dante Corleone. He's like the big man in the middle for Cincinnati. And so the middle of their D-line's pretty solid. The rest of the team, Emory Jones at quarterback, he's okay. He's got some athletic ability here and there. I think if you force Emory Jones to be a passer, it's going to be a long day for Cincinnati. So, end of the day, I do expect Oklahoma to roll here. I would love a 42-17 type of win. That's my favorite score. OU can hold them under 20 points. It'll be the first time they've held four teams straight under 20 points since 2006. So I know this is a 14-point spread. People have this game a little bit closer. If Oklahoma can make a little bit of a statement here, I think that really helps their cause in the long run. If it's a close game, but it's a close game in a sense where since he covers the spread with a backdoor cover late and the score looks closer than the game really was, that wouldn't shock me either. But again, if this is the next step here, because if we're all being honest with ourselves, Iowa State at home next week, we're trying to decide who's worse, Iowa State or Oklahoma State this year. Like, this feels like you get past this game, you get to come home, it's a game where you just, like, don't get anyone hurt, play your game, and then you get ready for the big one in Dallas. So, but one step at a time. Cincinnati tomorrow. Big sunrise kickoff, so we got that going for us. It won't be a night game, so that's one advantage we got. We'll hopefully get in there, get out, and come back home with a W. So, with all that, planning the watch along for tomorrow. And we'll see how things go for Oklahoma. But until then, see y'all later. Boomer Sooner.